Hi, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to your favorite show, the show which is totally dedicated to young leaders. Today, I have the pleasure to receive Mr. Roger Mendy. Roger, could you please introduce yourself?
Well, first and foremost, I'd like to thank you, Mr. Barasan, for your program. And I think this is a very relevant program that is the speech of youth, the speech of young people. And I think young people need to listen to these kind of speeches. Well, as the name goes, I am Roger Gomez. Actually, I'm a teacher of English in Binyona, but I am a member of Marine Family English Club, which is one of the greatest English club in all around Dakar, in all around Senegal. Yes, thank you.
Well, Brother Roger, we have noticed that, there are a lot of violences here in Senegal. So, according to you, what are the causes and the consequences of violence here in Senegal?
Truly speaking, talking about violence in Senegal, this is a very relevant and a very topical topic, as people would say. Violence in the broader, let's say, span of the term can be divided into different steps, into different aspects. We can have what we call physical violence, verbal violence. There is also what we call domestic violence. And there's also violence at school. Well, violence in Senegal, this is a big problem because, today, in the streets, in the schools, in the families, we can experience certain things that we did not use, we used not to know in the past, that we couldn't see in the past. This is mostly when I would like to jump to the chapter of the causes of the violence in Senegal. There are numerous points that we can point out. Well, I can point out first the lack of education. I can say that the first cause of violence is lack of education, because if the youngsters, they were educated enough, we wouldn't see this kind of violence, because if the youngsters are educated, we would close the jails. But now jails are full of people, jails are full of young people. This is because of lack of education. And when I talk of education, I'm not only talking about education at school. There's also education at home, which we call upbringing. There is education at school. There is education in the streets, because in the past, we would say a young man is a young boy or a young girl is a child of everybody. Meaning if you do something bad, even outside, another man can see you or another woman can see you and punish you or correct you. But today, such a thing cannot exist because of what we call modernism. And still talking about the causes of violence here in Senegal, one can find as a cause the fact that the young people don't have job right now. Meaning many of them are not trained, well trained. And what is the reason of that lack of training? This is there is a big span, a big rate of joblessness. People don't have jobs. And some of them who have some diplomas even, they very difficultly find a job. Okay, and this can be part of the reason why people are violent now, mostly the young people, because imagine most of them are sitting at the corners in the districts making tea. Sometimes they would like to do something. They'd like to buy something. For example, they don't have money. What can they do? Or what do they choose to do? They start mugging. They start mugging and attacking people, assaulting them just so as to take their money. Okay, there's also what we call domestic violence, which is the violence between husband and wife that we can find in a family. Well, one can say that things are changing, times are changing, because in the past, we wouldn't have this type of violence. Very often. It would be really very rare. But now this is very current. Every time you go to the court, there is a domestic violence. The judge is there judging some domestic violence. And this is mostly due to the fact that in the past, when a woman or when a girl would get married, she would get married to the whole family, not only to her husband. But now what happens is many times the young boys and the young girls, what do? They say, myself, you as my wife and our children, and we go and found our own family. They leave their fathers and mothers' families, and they stick together. They live together, and they forget about everything. They cut the bridges that would link them and that could help them tighten the links between them. Meaning the help of and the surrounding of the family of the boy or the family of the girl. But now we cannot have that.
Well, thanks, Master Roger. So, what can you tell us about the consequences?
Well, I think to talk about the consequences of violence, I think everybody knows, because Because of that much violence in Senegal, many young people die in the streets. Yeah, many young people die in the streets because they are used to be part of some violence. They are used to partake in violence. And you can see violence in the stadiums also. Many young people die. And imagine those young people, they might be the breadwinners of their own family. Imagine I draw an example from myself. I'm the eldest son of my family. Imagine if I go outside and I get mugged and I get stabbed and I get killed. What will my family do? Because they rely on me so as to survive. They now live and they're surviving. They rely on myself so as to survive, and they rely on my young brothers and sisters so as to survive. But if we are not lucky enough and we have been stabbed and we die, who will take care of our family? Who will take care of our mother and our fathers? Who will take care of our young siblings? This is one of the consequences. And another consequence of violence is, all right, and another thing is when you watch TV most of the time, those who must embody justice, when you see them breaking that justice, this is another violence also. And this is a bad image that they are showing to the young people. Imagine you watch TV and there is something at the National Assembly. Yes, I was saying, like, when you watch TV and you see the way our MPs, I mean, our members of parliament are used to behaving at the National Assembly, this is kind of shameful. And this is showing a bad image, I was saying a moment ago, to the youngsters, because they must be some examples. But they don't know that what they're doing is having a bad consequence on the young people, because they will say that, well, this is the way our leaders are used to behaving. Then this is the right example for us to behave. And this is not good for the development of a country. Because a country that is developed, if you look at the examples of many countries that are developed today, the like of China, the like of Korea, and many Asian countries that are developed today, those countries are part of the most, where we have the most polite young people, the most polite young generation. Yes, because this is the way they have been abroad. This is the way they have been taught at school. But this is not the case in Senegal. This is not the case, because what we see on TV, what we see from our political leaders, what we see from some of our elders, this is not a good example. And this is driving the young people into the back track. And this is not good, because the future of a country lays in the hands of the young generation. And if that young generation is not well educated, if that young generation is not shown the right track, the right example, then this is very bad for the future of a country.
Yeah, Master Roger, what you have just said is interesting, really. So what kind of piece of advice can you give to the new generation?
Well, actually, to the young generation, we can give a lot of advice. Even though we are still young, I mean, Africanly speaking, because were we European or American people, we would not be considered as young people. Yes, but Africanly speaking, we are still young, but we can still contribute to, let's say, the change of mentalities, the change of minds. I think this young generation needs to be guided correctly. And who should be guiding us? Those are leaders, those are teachers. And fortunately, I'm a teacher. And in my classrooms, I'm doing my level best. I'm doing my damnedest every God-given day to teach my students not only English, but also how to behave outside of school. Because if you don't know how to behave outside of school, then it will not be good for you, and your education at school is for nothing. All right. But mostly, the first thing to do is to sensitize parents one more time, because children are no longer brought up in houses. Children are let to do whatever they want. Children do whatever they want. And this is the upbringing they have in the houses that they project outside and that they project in the schools. This is why today also we have violence in schools. All right. And another piece of advice is, like, I think even if you don't have a job right now, even if you don't have a good training right now, but this is not a reason for you to veer off course. This is not the reason for you to say to yourself, well, I don't have money and I am going to mug, or I am going to steal, or I am going to do some bad deeds. This is not a good mindset. This is not a good mentality. And I think all revealed religion teach the same thing, nearly the same thing, which is, like, don't do bad thing to other people. Treat the other people the way you would like to be treated yourself. Right. If you treat other people badly, then expect a bad treatment from other people too, or from Allah, or from God, or whatever the name you give him. Right. Then young people must stand up tighten their belt, roll up their sleeves, and get ready to work hard. Because only work can develop not only a country, but also a person. Because before we have the development of the country, we must firstly have the development of people or families, and that will in a long term transform into the development of a country. Then, as I said a moment ago, the future of the country lays in the hands of the young generation, and education, as Malcolm X would say, is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Thank you very much.
Thank you much, Roger. That's so interesting. So what's your last word?
Actually, as a last word to Talk Turkey, I'd like to thank you, Mr. Barasan, for your invitation, because this is not obvious, and I'm truly beholden to you for having me as a guest on your YouTube channel program. And this is a very interesting program, the speech of the youth, because I'm used to following you on YouTube, and I watched your last video with that author and the student at the same time at Cihangir University. This is what I would say. This country needs some people like you, and Yimbil needs some leaders like you, who not only encourage people, inspire people, motivate people, but help them build a bright future. I cannot end without saying anything about our English club, the greatest English club, Marae Family English Club, which is my English club, your English club, our English club, because I think all of us, or the two of us, have been trained in that EC, and this is the reason why we can stand today. We can sit today and try to express ourselves in this Shakespearean language. And I can remind people just a small anecdote. When I was coming to Marae Family, I couldn't speak English. I couldn't even introduce myself. The same case for you. But today you are holding a program in English, and this is highly thanks to Marae Family. Marae Family English Club, go up, up and up. Thank you.
Thank you, Master Roger. Rendezvous 2 weeks at the same time. Same place. Thank you.